Why are yawns contagious? The average adult yawns 20 times per day, so why does being around other yawners make you yawn more? We asked Georgetown University neuroscientist James Giordano.
The $25,000 question is whether or not yawns are contagious, and the answer seems to be pretty much. The reason for that is still unknown. There seems to be some issue called echopraxia, where people see certain things, and if they're sensitive to them, they'll do the same thing. We see this in other behaviors. Somebody scratching their nose, somebody rubbing their chin. Very often, others will mimic that behavior. Sometimes just seeing someone yawn can be enough, but very often when it's accompanied by that yawning sound, and you know how that sound goes, that's the that people will often make. Sometimes just that sound alone, particularly if the circumstances are conducive, would be enough to induce a contagious yawn. And it becomes even more curious because we know that in some cases, other species will do the same thing. Dogs, cats, and even some reptiles. And interestingly, if those dogs and those cats are socialized in the same household we are, we may have cross-species yawning contagion. But the reason we yawn when other people yawn seems to be due to a whole host of mechanisms. Social mechanisms, mechanisms of psychology, and certainly there is some type of an underlying neurobiology. The most probable reason for that is that we're getting sensitive to whatever is our underlying physiological state, and when other people begin to yawn, it sort of gives us a trip, a trigger. It prompts us to become more sensitized to that, and your brain sort of goes, yeah, that sounds like a good idea. I think I'll do that too. The neuroscience of yawning has really been enthused in recent years by developments in what's called neuroimaging. We're able to find out what brain areas, nodes, and networks become active when an individual is susceptible to a yawn, engaging the yawn, and has finished the yawn. And yawning seems to occupy a fair amount of neurological real estate in the brain. We certainly know that when we see someone yawn, there's activation in our visual cortex and associative cortex. I see you doing something. I'm seeing that, and I'm sort of feeling it myself. This is where we may or may not engage these populations of mirror neurons, as they're called. Mirror neurons were a group of neurons that were identified at first in the brains of primates, and it seems that what these neurons are involved in is matching what we sense to what we feel and the way we move. If you see me scratching my cheek, or if you see me adjusting my tie, very often, you'll at very, very least feel what that may feel like. On some level, you may even be compelled to do it, and it appears that, at least in part, yawning involves this type of mechanism. If you're in the same space across a period of time, and they begin to experience a contextual effect and a circumstantial effect that's similar to yours, well, gotcha. They might, in fact, yawn. So it's contextual, it's biological, it's psychological, but it certainly seems to be contagious. Did my yawns make you yawn? Talking about yawning make you feel like you had to yawn, or are you suppressing a yawn now? And if so, I hope it's because I didn't bore you.